Hello, I'm Dr. Jennifer Davis, and I'm a member of the Centre for Intellectual Property and Information Law at the Law Faculty of the University of Cambridge. And I'm here to talk to you about the EU and intellectual property. Now, intellectual property, trademarks, patents, copyright, designs, and confidential information has often been called the product of the mind. But generally, it's embodied in physical objects, a copyright work in a book, a trademark on a piece of clothing. Now, the intellectual property has been a major preoccupation of the EU for quite a period of time. There are a couple of reasons for this. Intellectual property, being abstract, easily crosses national boundaries, so that if I go to the EU, I will find a can of Coca-Cola with the brand Coca-Cola on it everywhere in the EU, even though perhaps it was bottled in only one member state. The other reason why there is this preoccupation is precisely because intellectual property crosses international boundaries so easily, so it's important for the EU to have a system to protect intellectual property which is uniform across the market, since creating a single market is one of its key goals. So in the past few years, trademark law has been harmonized across the whole of the EU. It is possible to get an EU-registered trademark, and also an EU-registered design, and there's an EU-unregistered design. There are a number of directives relating to copyright, such as the directive which means that there's the same length of protection for copyright works all across the EU. A European patent is soon to be introduced, and recently a directive on trade secret was passed to ensure that all the European EU countries give the same level of protection for trade secrets. So what would happen if Britain votes to leave the EU? Well, possibly we could be like Norway and stay within the European Economic Area. That way, we would continue to share in the laws relating to the protection of intellectual property in the European Union, but of course we would have no say in how they're framed. What happens if we leave completely? Well, after a few years, our intellectual property protection will begin to diverge from other member states. Now, for some, that would be a good thing, and they would perhaps point to the overprotection that they believe is given to intellectual property within the EU. A prominent case, for example, is that of when L'Oreal, the perfume company, sued Belleur, also a perfume company, for trademark infringement. Belleur was selling cheap, smell-alike perfumes, which they described as trésor, in one sense as smelling like trésor, which was a registered trademark of L'Oreal. The Court of Justice of the European Union found that, in fact, Belleur had infringed the trademark of L'Oreal by doing this because they said they had free-ridden or had taken advantage of L'Oreal's investment in its mark. But for its critics, many of its critics in the UK, what the decision had done was to have impinged upon freedom of speech. After all, Belleur was only telling the truth about the smell of its perfume, and also harmed consumers because they were not able to know the truth about a much cheaper perfume. What about if we stay? Well, those who believe that we should stay within the EU say it makes perfect sense that when you have an asset like intellectual property, which so easily crosses international boundaries, it makes sense to have a regime which covers and gives the same protection throughout this area of trading. So if you're a startup company in the UK, it will be cheap and easy for you to protect your trademark throughout the European Union, and soon it will be the case with your patent as well. In the same way, if you are a company in the United States, perhaps, or in Japan that wants to enter the EU market, again, it will be simple and easy for you to protect your trademark, your registered design perhaps, soon to be your patent in the European Union, in a way that will enhance your ability to move between states and perhaps also benefit consumers because you can perhaps charge less for the product. There is one final point worth making. Intellectual property is obviously very valuable both for the UK and for the EU more generally. Yet in the past few months, in the course of the debate, none of the main protagonists, either for staying or leaving the EU, has felt it necessary to talk about the issue of intellectual property. Now, I think that says something, not perhaps about intellectual property in the EU, but certainly about the standard of the debate.